तरूण तेजपालाच्या केसी भितर आयिल्ली जजमेंट आनी ताजी ऑर्डर. फाटले 4-5 दीस आमकां हें निर्णय कळिल्लो न्यायालयाचो, पूण तो निर्णय कित्या खातीर, ताजे फाटलें रजांव कितें तें आमकां खबर नाशिल्लें. ताजी ऑर्डर आतां आमच्या हाताक लागला. काल राती आमी ही स्टोरी ब्रेक केल्ली. नक्की ही ऑर्डर कितें म्हणटा आनी फुडें कितें, ह्या गजालीचेर आमी उलयतले. सगळ्यांत पयलीं म्हाका जॉयन जातात आमचे क्रायम आनी लिगल सिनियर रिपोर्टर मुकेश कुमार. मुकेश, वील गो इन टू द डिटेल्स लेटर, बट वॉट आर द सेलियंट पॉयंट्स दॅट आर रेज्ड इन दीस ऑर्डर बेज्ड ऑन विच तरूण तेजपाल इज एक्विटेड?
The prosecution's case was that in November 2013, during an official event in a hotel in Goa, accused Tarun Tejpal committed rape to a junior colleague in a lift on two occasions. So later on, the victim girl could not immediately went to the Goa police, and later on when this matter went to the office, then Tarun Tejpal wrote two letters to the victim girl and the entire staff saying that he has crossed his limit and he is shameful for that, and he is seeking atonement in terms of he will not attend office for next 6 months. So anyhow, it came into media, and later on, taking suo motu cognizance of this issue, Goa police registered FIR, and the Sunita Savant, who is investigating officer in this case, was complainant in this matter, and then FIR was registered. Later on, the victim girl came on the record and recorded a statement and give details of all these things, then how this rape was committed. So main point was that he committed rape in the lift, and usually lift takes hardly 30 seconds to 1 minute from going to one floor to another floor, but according to complainant girl, Tarun Tejpal put the lift in circuit, and during that period the doors were not open of the lift, and he committed the rape. So this was the background of that case. Now I'm coming on the main points of the judgment, in which the trial court has said that it is greatest distress and humiliation to the victim in a rape case, but at the same point, a false allegation of rape can cause an equal distress and humiliation and damage to the accused as well. So this was the principle of the trial court. And then later on, given many examples, the trial court has said that there are many evidences on record which create doubt on the truthfulness of the complainant girl, and again the finger is raised on the investigation officer by the court, saying that the investigation of officer did not perform her duty honestly, and there was omission and commission in the investigation. So court has said that it seems that investigation officer intentionally did not investigate in the part where it can go in the favor of accused Tarun Tejpal. So this is the case in which CCTV footage was very crucial evidence in this case. So first floor of 7th block of the hotel was the crime scene, and according to the trial court, CCTV footage of that floor was destroyed, and investigation officer did not perform at the right time to procure or to seize that DVR, due to which the CCTV footage was destroyed. According to defense side, and the trial court also agreed that CCTV footage which is there of the other block or other cameras, it shows that the girl has followed Tarun Tejpal after the alleged crime. So all there were many circumstantial evidences on which the trial court has come on the conclusion giving benefit of doubt to Tarun Tejpal. Pramod,
Mukesh, what does the order say? These are the salient points based on which court arrived at that decision, but any other major points that are there in the judgment which are which you can highlight, which are important and which we did not know before?
Yes, the thing is that the victim girl who made this accusation she was silent for many days. As I told you earlier, that this FIR was registered taking Suomoto cognizance of media reports that a rape has been committed by Tarun Tejpal in Goa. And then Sunita Sawant went to the crime branch and the FIR was registered. And she was only the investigation officer in this matter. But when we go about the statement of the complainant girl, she said that this matter, the crime was committed, and later on she did not went to Delhi or Mumbai at her place, residential place in Mumbai, saying that she was traumatized and due to which she did not approach to police, and she took time to approach police. But the court says that there are many doubts over the statement made by the victim girl. As there are pages of WhatsApp communication between many friends of that victim girl. So court, after going through all those WhatsApp communication messages, court has come on the conclusion that the victim girl was not traumatized as a rape victim usually happen. So this was the main thing, and there are many statements which has been recorded during the trial. Court feels that the statement was of the victim girl was improvised by herself. So she is saying that court feels that she was not very much true about this issue. Another thing was that all this started when Tarun Tejpal wrote a letter of through the official email ID to all the employees, which was written from the tahalka.com email ID. But during the investigation, the server of tahalka.com was not seized by the investigating officer. So there is a question over the authenticity of all those emails, which is, according to the prosecution, it was the main piece of evidence that how can some make confession without any guilt. So some confession was made by Tarun Tejpal, but court feels that the server is not attached. So there is not not evidence beyond doubt that that may be tampered, that email can be tampered. So the technical issue arises here, that server is not attached. Another issue was that lift, according to complainant girl, Tarun Tejpal kept that lift in circuit by pressing one button, but investigating officer failed to show that how that can that lift can be taken in the circuit. So these are the technical issues and part of investigation which, according to the trial court, investigation officer intentionally did not investigate on these parts, and benefit of doubt goes to Tarun Tejpal. Also, there are many other issues which I want to tell you. CCTV footage indicates that the lift, in fact, opened twice on the ground floor, whereas the complainant girl claimed that the lift did not open at all. But CCTV footage indirectly shows that some light is coming, which usually comes after opening of the door of that lift. Another thing is that IO has admitted that there is contradiction between CCTV footage and statement of the complainant girl, yet IO did not record supplementary statement. This is crucial to note that contradictions are often so glaring that the exact opposite of the what complainant girl is claiming. Yet IO did not question the complainant girl. So court has mainly raised question over the truthfulness of the complainant girl, and later on some technical aspect of this case, like complainant was Sunita Sawant, so she should not be the investigating officer of the case. Some other officer should have been the investigating officer in this case.
I think एक गजल अतु भीतर सामकी महत्वाची असा जी या मुकेश या गो अहेड ओके आई विल गो बैक टू मुकेश. आई थिंक एक गजल अतु भीतर सामकी महत्वाची आ की दोन तीन गजाली म्हणजे जेन्ना वर्डिक्ट येतगीर तरुण तेजपालान सांगिल्ले सीसीटीव्ही फुटेज ती सीसीटीव्ही फुटेज डेफिनेटली क्रुशल झाल्या. त्याचबरोबर ऑन स्पॉट लिफ्ट वचपाचो टायम ओपन जावपाचो टायम त्यो सगळ्यो गजाली क्रुशल झाल्यात. आनीक कंप्लेनंट आयओ आनीक इन्वेस्टिगेशन करपी पुलीस अफसर हे दोगे जाण सेम आसात वही जाला. या मुकेश कंटिन्यू.
Another thing, I told you that about the server of tahalka.com was not seized. And later on, the court has held that it is settled proposition that acquittal of the accused cannot be result due to defect in the investigation.
Hmm.
The evidences have to be scrutinized independently. One thing I want to tell you.
Okay, we'll go back to Mukesh on that. But he ordered. म्हाका सांगचें दिसता की अपलोड जाता म्हळ्यार 4 ते 5 दीस गेले आनीक वॉट वी नो रायट नाव इज दॅट 550 पानाची 550 पेजीसाची ही ऑर्डर आसा. सो तुमी इमेजीन करात कितली बल्की ऑर्डर आहा ती. येस मुकेश कंटिन्यू.
So one thing I want to say that it is a 527 page judgment.
Hmm.
And it is very well written. One side prosecution is very feel that justice is not done. As we know that state government has already filed appeal before the high court saying that this is not justice.
Hmm.
And the evidences are not evaluated. But after reading the judgment, one thing I want to tell you that definitely it is the major ground for which goes in the favor of accused.
Hmm.
Because every answer which was raised at the time of registration of FIR, I am covering this case for last 7-8 years, rather very first day. So there were 2-3 main issues. One thing was that why Tarun Tejpal wrote that letter if he was not committed any offense.
Mm.
So reply is that the doubt is there that server was not seized by the investigating officer. Another thing is that crime was committed in the lift, but how many times the lift was in circuit, and why did the complainant girl not press the panic button? There is one emergency button which can be switch on to raise alarm or to stop the lift. So that was not used. So these are the main points on the basis of which court feels that benefit of doubt should go in the favor of accused.
So if you analyze this 550 page judgment, it more and more looks like completely based on technical grounds that prosecution failed to present the technical evidence that is required to prove that Tarun Tejpal is guilty beyond doubt. Am I right?
Yes, that is there. But all 3 points I'm telling you. One, the technical point, like complainant should not be the investigating officer, number one. Number two, why the server was not attached. Number three, why not police investigated in this matter that how can the lift can be kept in circuit? The control panel of the lift was not seized, or the operator was not asked the technical aspect of this thing, that how can lift can be kept in circuit, and how can it be prohibited from opening the door. So these are the technical issues. And another thing that the major part is that the contradiction in the statement of the complainant girl, the so-called victim girl. Court feels that a statement recorded at the time of registration of FIR, after registration of FIR, later on 164 statement was registered. Later on, during the trial, she was cross-examined. So at all these points, it seems court felt that she has improvised her statement. So it seems that court has clearly written that there are many evidences on record which create doubt on the truthfulness of the complainant girl. And later on, it also says that in this case, the prosecution has failed to discharge the burden of proving the guilt of the accused beyond reasonable doubt. So all these points are there which went in the favor of Tarun Tejpal.
Mukesh, another issue, I think Goa police lost DYSP stationed in Panji. Please tell us more about it.
Yes, it is very sad, Pramod, that we have lost Uttam Rao Desai, DYSP Uttam Rao Desai, who was SDPO for Panji, Old Goa and Agasem police station. And he was very jolly person. As I remember, he was the very open and frank speaking person. And recently, I think in the month of February this year, he had to undergone open heart surgery. Later on, after 1 month, he was hospitalized, and later on when he recovered a little bit, I'm not telling you he was fully recovered, but he joined the office back. He used to come, even I asked that, why do you come to the office in this situation? He said that I feel bored at home. That's why it is better to come in the office. And he used to perform all his duty very well. And once I met him in the GMC also in the month of April. And I asked him that, why are you here? He said that I come to regular checkup of COVID. So he said that my health condition is not good. So I have to be very cautious. So I, on the routine basis, I get checkup for the COVID. And then for last few days, he was feeling some complication. I'm not very much sure officially. It has not said that he died due to COVID. But he was having some complication that might be due to COVID also, and his condition due to open heart surgery. He passed away last night, and of course, I remember him as a very good officer, very good human being, and good, of course, administrator as DYSP.
Thanks a lot, Mukesh, for bringing us all those updates.